Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a Hyundai Tucson. If you guys have a Hyundai Tucson and you need to remove or replace camshaft, exhaust or intake camshaft, stay with us. We'll explain guys how to do that. It's not very complicated, but it's just time consuming. And we'll cover everything from start to finish, so stay with us. It will be a very helpful video that can save you quite a bit of money. That should work on a 2.4 GDI engine, but it may actually be helpful and teach you what needs to be done on some other engines as well. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need guys in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep providing this free information to you. Now, if you need to buy new camshafts, parts, tools for a really good price and quick shipping as well, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where we get all our tools and supplies from. So this is the engine right here that we'll be demonstrating on. This is a 2.4 GDI. It will be the same way being in the vehicle, but we'll be making hundreds of videos that can potentially save you thousands of dollars. And with the engine being out, we can clearly show you things, guys. So now, number one, okay, let's explain something. Before you start, you need to disconnect the car battery. Why? Because it will be removing the high pressure fuel pump, fuel lines, you will leak fuel and you can catch yourself on fire. By disconnecting the car battery, you can reduce that risk. It still exists, but you can reduce it. And on these modern cars, it really matters which battery terminal you disconnect and reconnect first. Do it the wrong way, guys, and you can cause damage to the engine computer and the electrical system. So we have a special video that explains the proper way to disconnect the car battery and reconnect it. I'll put the link in the description of the video below. Number two, have a fire extinguisher on the side, protective gloves, high protection. Also, what you want to do guys, okay, make sure the engine is cold, it's not hot because you will be spilling fuel, and make sure that you don't have an open flame, spark, anything next to you, no smoking. Now, with that being said, okay, that's the valve cover right here. In order to remove it now, okay, what do we need to do? We need to come here on the back side. Okay, that's the exhaust VVT solenoid. We need to disconnect it here. We need to go ahead and disconnect the wires for that. And you can even reach through the holes here and squeeze them if you're afraid that you can break them. Now, right here, those things, okay, those gray things for the for the ignition coils, they need to, okay, come out. That's the safety locks. Once they come out, you press down. Okay, and you pull them out. If it's stuck, what you can do, push in, then press down, and then disconnect it. Perfect. Now, right here, we need to disconnect the high, the volume for the high pressure fuel pump, volume sensor. So we'll go ahead and disconnect that one, and disconnect it right here. Over there, guys. Okay, let me show you now. Okay, right here we have two bolts that we'll need to remove. We need to remove ignition coils as well, so we can flip the wiring harness to the side. So let's go ahead, do that now. Okay, perfect. Now, we have some there. Perfect, ignition coils came out. Now, right here you have the intake hose, we have it removed, but you will be able to either disconnect it from the intake hose or from right here, it's up to you. Next, we'll disconnect the fuel line. Before we continue, here you have the low pressure fuel line. If you don't know how to disconnect it, we have a special video on our channel, how to disconnect fuel line on a Hyundai on our main YouTube channel, Auto Repair Guys. Then, you will be probably leaking fuel, but carefully disconnect, okay, that line as well. Okay, that's a high pressure fuel line. Perfect, now that line practically, okay, can come out like that. Now, let's see what else we have here. Okay, PCV hose. Let's go ahead and remove that PCV hose, okay, to be out of the way, not to forget it. Two bolts for the high pressure fuel pump, just remove a little bit one, then the other one, not one all at sudden, because it's spring loaded pump, and depending on where it stopped on the camshaft, you can have quite a bit of tension. Also guys, that will be the time to inspect your tappet, okay, because that one, Okay, if it fails, it can destroy your engine. Okay, and you don't want that to happen. Okay, we'll have a link in the description of the video below where you can buy a replacement one from. So our pump practically stopped at a point where it didn't have too much pressure. Now, right here, we need to start removing all the bolts for the valve cover. So, starting from the back there. You can see where all the bolts are. Okay, they will come out, guys. Okay, be prepared, they will come out. Now, in the middle, we have five more. 1, 2, 3, 4. Because this one we gotta lose. 2 for the next fuel pump there. We need to remove those as well. Perfect. Now, you grab each one of the bolts. Okay. And we need to pull them out. Okay, I dropped another one. You have to be kind of like careful. Okay, not to drop them. Perfect. So, we have a few more here. Okay, great. 2 more. Let's see, I don't think we have more bolts. Now, right here we have okay, that's a mount for a wire. We need to just pull it to the side a little bit. Now, that gasket may be stuck depending how bad your valve cover could be stuck depending on how bad the gasket is, and you can see the valve cover came out just like that. So now, let me show you what we'll be doing here. We're going to go ahead, okay, and we will remove the serpentine belt. That's a serpentine belt tensioner. You go counterclockwise, we remove the belt, pull it out, okay, and now that's where things get a little bit more complicated now, guys. In order to remove the crankshaft pulley, okay, the engine will be turning, okay, clockwise and counterclockwise. So what you will need to do in that case, okay, there is a special tool that it can fix the crankshaft so it doesn't move. Okay, and it will be able to remove that bolt and get it tight to the required torque specs. Now, usually we found a way, okay, to remove it without using special tools, but I will not recommend it. What we are going to do, okay, now we're going to remove the intake manifold. We have it pre-loosened here so we can, guys, okay, show you where you can install that special tool. There are two kind of tools. One is on the engine starter, one is on the underneath the oil pan on the flywheel, and if you install that tool, it's going to set the crankshaft and you can remove it. If you don't have that tool, it's something I don't recommend. We usually use, okay, that air compressor that we'll put the link in the description of the video below, the air gun. That's a high torque gun. That compressor pumps all the way to 165 PSI, which is unbelievable for that little compressor. And we just practically go ahead, okay, and pre-loosen it with that. So we got our pre-loosened already, but stay with us until the end, and we're going to explain where actually, guys, okay, where you can install the special tool for the crankshaft. Now, that one, our battery is short on it. We need to replace our battery on the little impact, but we pre-loosen it with the big one. And it's still holding a little bit, so we'll go ahead and change the battery and remove it. But this compressor and that impact, usually they don't have problem removing the bolt. Now, installation is where you need to get it tight to certain torque specs, and we'll put the we'll have the video on the channel. But now, you don't want to, guys, okay, you don't want actually to do that without a special tool, because you will be kind of like guessing how tight it is. Even though it's a keyed pulley, that's a good design. Okay, it did get loose. So now we can go ahead, okay, and pull the crankshaft pulley out of here. You can see just like that. If you want to see the video, guys, how to remove the intake manifold and remove the engine starter, we have the video on the channel. Okay, it's actually going to teach you how to do that step by step. So we removed the intake manifold, engine starter has been removed. Okay, so we can show you where you can install that special tool, but practically you remove, that's where your engine starter will be. You insert it right here with the bolts and it goes on the flywheel, which is right here. It goes in the teeth of the flywheel, so that way you can securely, okay, remove the bolt. So you get the idea, guys. So now for that oil pan, you need to make sure that the engine oil is drained completely. You have no engine oil, so the oil drain port is on the back side right there. Go ahead, remove it and collect the oil, drain it. Now 12 millimeter socket, guys, and we need to start working here. We need to remove, okay, these bolts for that bracket, okay, right there, that we need to do. And we need to remove the two bolts on the AC compressor on the bottom side. Okay, those need to come out as well. Now, that bracket, we'll have one more bolt. I think it has three bolts altogether. One is deep, hidden. Okay, right there, you can see, perfect, just like that. Came out, and one on the back side, so four bolts. Or three bolts. Three bolts, I believe it was. Let me see. No, four. There is one more hidden behind the AC compressor. Okay, so we need to go here. Okay, make sure that you hold the bracket, it's going to drop. Now, why you need to remove that? Because without it, you cannot remove the oil pan. And here you have two huge bolts, guys. Okay, these two huge bolts that are with 12 millimeter socket, and they actually hold the crankcase, the bottom side of the engine, to the engine block. And those are super long, and they can be, okay, let us show you how long they are. Okay, perfect. And those can be extremely tight, so if you have hard time removing them, you know why. Okay, that's what they look like, a 12-point socket. Now, there is no gasket holding that oil pan. The only thing holding it is, after you remove the bolts, will be silicone gasket maker, and we will explain which one to use that we recommend quite often here at the shop. So we'll just go ahead and start removing each of the bolts now. Okay, one by one, we'll just go ahead and remove all the bolts with 10 millimeter socket now. So that's what we're working on now. And now we need to have more there. Perfect. Two, three towards the back side, and then we come around and we start removing all of those here. Then we have silicone on those bolts. They may not come out as easy. Okay, let me turn the light on so you can probably see better. Perfect. Now, right there. So, if you see right here, okay, let's see if we have more bolts holding. To make sure, probably we have towards the backside one. Ours came loose because it had a leak, okay, and somebody didn't reseal it correctly, so we want to explain how to reseal it. Okay, the oil pan came out, we still have a little bit of engine oil. Now we'll be rebuilding that engine, and it's not connecting rod from what we can see because of a bad connecting rod bearing, and we'll have the videos about that as well. Now you need to clean the oil pan really good. You need to get a scraper, clean it really good. If you bent it somewhere trying to pry it out, it's just a metal pan, so you can go ahead, straighten it, make it level, and you need to clean it. You do use alcohol, rubbing alcohol, to clean it. Clean the engine block where it's going to be on, and you need to put silicone gasket maker, high temp. This is a great one. I'll put the link in the description of the video below. Put it on the inner side of the bolt and around the bolts, go with silicone, and probably a bit I would say probably about a 3-4 millimeters go around, and then you need to install the oil pan and get it tight, guys. So you can see that's how you remove it practically. So once we remove the oil pan, okay, right here, we remove the valve cover already. Oil pan's been removed. You don't need to remove the intake manifold for the valve cover, but we made our videos, guys, how to do it. And if you're using the special tools for the crankshaft pulley, you will need to remove the intake manifold. If you want to see the video, it's on our channel. We pre-loosened the 3 bolts actually for the for the water pump pulley here, so we can go ahead, remove those. Okay, and it will come out simply just like that. Next, we need to remove the tensioner pulley right here. We should not forget to do that. First, that bolt right here, excuse me, is reverse threaded. So in order to get it loose, you go clockwise instead of counterclockwise. Okay, the other way. Nope, we need to use the wrench because it got quite tight, because every time you install the belt, you actually get it tight. Okay, it came loose. So let's go ahead, remove that one. Perfect. Now we need to remove that bolt here for the tensioner pulley, because there is one hidden bolt and the timing cover is right there as well. So let's do that now. That's normal threaded bolt here, only the pulley was reverse threaded. We need to remove that pulley here, not to forget. So let's do that. Perfect, out. Now, we need to remove the mount for the bracket for the engine mount that supports the engine mount. So we're supposed to have 14 millimeter bolts, but somebody just used different bolts here because they probably lost them. One of them seems like, okay, well, let's leave it on the thing and we can just pull it that way so we can remember where every bolt is. Perfect, just like that. That's the timing cover. Now, stay until the end, guys, because if you do something wrong, you can severely damage it. Right here, we have 2 metal guides that you can pre-soak with penetrating spray. One here, one there, while you're working, so it can start eating that rust, because otherwise, okay, they'll be really stuck and you can have a hard time removing the timing cover. We're getting a 12 millimeter socket now, and we start removing the bolts. All right. Perfect. Now, let's see what else, okay, we can do here. Ten millimeter bolts, we need to remove all of these now. Perfect. Now, let's actually go ahead and see if it's going to come out. You have silicone sealant that's, that can be stuck, and these 2 metal guides don't pry too much. If you do, you can crack it. If it doesn't go, just go a little bit here, here, on every angle. That way, okay, it can come loose, because if you don't pre-treat those, you don't soak them, you'll be really hard to pull that timing cover. Now, that timing cover, you will need to clean the silicone really good. That old silicone needs to just come out, clean it, clean the engine block, the cylinder head here, use rubbing alcohol to make sure that it's not greasy, and later you will need to use a high temp gasket maker, which will put the link in the description of the video below, and you will need to apply on the inner side of the bolts, guys, okay, a thin bead. After that, you use the same stuff for the oil pan as well. So next step, guys, what we're going to do, okay, we're going to actually bring all the pistons in the middle, okay, not to have one up, one down, because the one up, if we remove the chain, what can happen, okay, the camshafts sometimes are spring loaded and we can knock the valves a little bit and maybe bend them. We don't want that to happen, so we'll remove the spark plugs, okay, and we'll verify, okay, that practically all the pistons are in the middle. If you Okay, never do that, but it's possible just to remove sinner number 3 and 4 or 1 and 2 and verify that. That way you will know, okay, because usually pistons 1 and 4 are together and 2 and 3. But what we'll do now, okay, this one, okay, is right here. So let's go ahead, okay, do that. And we'll need to remove cylinder number 3, okay, just in case as well. So let's go ahead, see the screwdriver is inside, go, okay, a little bit more, down, okay, like that. Okay, now let's go ahead, okay, and remove the other spark plugs as well. And we're going to verify that this one is not on top too. Okay, perfect. And let's do, okay, here now to see. So let's go clockwise a little bit. Okay. Okay, and I don't feel a piston, so it's right in the middle somewhere now. Perfect. I'm going to remove the screwdriver, not to damage something. Okay, and let us show you now. Okay, what do we need to do for the next step? We need to go ahead and remove the timing chain tensioner. Okay, right here. That will be the next thing to do. With 10 millimeter socket, we are going to go ahead and remove the two bolts. Perfect. One, two, came out. Now let's go ahead, remove the timing chain arm as well. You can see how that thing is spring loaded, it turned already. So in that case you can get a 14 millimeter and okay, I can get the slack out of it, and we'll remove the timing chain tensioner arm. Perfect. Now we have the timing chain guide right here. Perfect. We'll go ahead and remove that one. Comes out. Now, what else we need to do? You can practically go ahead, okay, if I go ahead and get the slack out of this one here now, okay, we can probably take the chain from the bottom, okay, and remove that chain. Okay, great. Now, the main chain came out. Now, what about the oil pump, okay, and the balance shaft chain right here? We recommend to replace that one as well, not just one of them, or some people will just replace the tensioners and the tensioner arm and the guide and not the chain itself. It's up to you, but we'll explain how to do it and what we'll recommend to do. So next we need to go ahead and remove the oil pump assembly underneath. Why? Because if you try to take that wheel off, that's part of the balance shaft, okay, and everything will be off and you will have terrible vibrations that will practically take your engine apart later, or it will be really, really vibrating bad. So you will need to get big tools, okay, we pre-loosen our bolts already for the oil pump and the balance shaft assembly, but usually those will be super tight. I think you have 7 bolts if I remember correctly. One is out. You can see how long some of those are. Now we go to, okay, let's see right there now. Number 2, perfect. Well, 1 minute, we need to wait. Okay, 3, I forgot. We need to first remove the tensioner, the arm and the guide, so we're all ready. So let's before we continue, let's go ahead, okay, remove those so everything will be ready, because the pump will just drop after that. So let's do those. No, this one here first. So no, let's go ahead and install it. Okay, tensioner first. Perfect. You always start with the tensioner first and then the other ones. This is not a hydraulic tensioner, this is just a spring loaded tensioner. That's a good thing. But the spring can get soft, and what can happen? Okay, you may lose tension and develop a rattle. Okay, and that can result into even the bounce shaft jump. Okay, and in that case, it will be terrible, or if the oil pump doesn't work, the engine will start for oil and practically it will destroy. So I think we're on boat number 4 now, if I remember correctly. And after that, we continue there. Okay, let's see. Now we have 2 more that I can see. 5. 1 more there, number 6, and we have 1 left for the front. Okay, right there. You need to hold the pump, it's heavy. Not to drop on it. Okay, now you tilt the pump this way. It has 2 metal guides, and lift it up now. Go up, and I'll pull the chain. Perfect. And that's the other chain as well, and we will. Okay, have the video on the channel, guys. Okay, how to install them in case you need to. Timing marks and timing chain installation and they Tucson. So now for next step, camshafts. Okay, what do we need to do? We need to remove the camshafts. Okay, but right here first you need to remove that mount for the high pressure fuel pump. It needs to come out. It has only 3 bolts that attach right here. So we'll go ahead, okay, remove those. It's not too complicated. And we can get to the camshafts, but it's very important the sequence in which you remove the camshafts. Otherwise, okay, you can cause damage. Perfect. We're ready here. Now, this one, just wiggle it a little bit and it will come out. Okay, perfect. Now, the first cap that needs to come is the one on this side with the 12 millimeters. So let's go ahead, do that. Great. Now we can pick this one up. Now, 10 millimeter, and we can go ahead and remove the one on the very right side. It's very important to install them exactly in the same order that you remove them. Otherwise, okay, you can develop problems, guys. Okay, so I think they might even, no, they're not marked. They're marked, no. So remove them exactly in the same, install them exactly in the same order you remove them. After this one, you go to this one, then you alternate and you go to the other outside one. Then we go to the middle one. Perfect. So, practically now, you can go ahead, grab it. Okay, it may be stuck a little bit, but it comes out. We'll put them on a box exactly in the same order that we removed them. And 2 more. Now we can go ahead, grab the camshafts, and we can pull them out. This is the intake one. And this is the exhaust camshaft right here, came out as well. Now, you have a bearing here, okay, that is for the exhaust camshaft, you have one bearing, okay, right here. So, you can see, we got them out. So, that's how you guys remove the camshafts. As you can see, both of them came out practically. Putting it together is in reverse order, we took it apart. We'll have the video about the camshaft cap stock specs on a Hyundai Tucson on our channel, so check it out, it's going to teach you that. Hopefully guys, the video will be helpful to any of you trying to figure this thing out. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to let us know. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.